Greetings all, the Devious Monkey here. Okay, this might backfire on me. I have decided that I was going to escape for a little bit because I've been sitting in Toyota dealerships for the past 2 days getting maintenance done and or sitting in my office and I'm pent up. I needed to get out. So I decided that I was going to take my Sony a7 R4 with the Sigma 100 to 400 and try it in APS-C mode and see if I get like really good reach. I didn't think that I was going to take to birding as much as I have. I actually really enjoy it. And I am now looking into even, I don't want to say bigger lenses, but longer reaching super telephoto lenses. The only one that would make sense for me to get would be the Sony 200 to 600. Granted, it's a slow lens, but the monkey don't have $13,000 to get a 600 F4. Yeah, not happening. So I thought that maybe I could get a tele extender, like a 1.4 or a 2x extender, which I had before for my Canon stuff. But of course, Sony's extenders only work with Sony's lenses. And Sigma's only work with their not Sony mount lenses. So that's not an option. I can't get one. So it wouldn't make sense for me to, let's say when I had the 70 to 200 f2.8 to get a 2x extender for it, because then it would still just give me 400 and I've already got 100 to 400. But if I got the 200 to 600, I'd have 200 millimeters more than I've got now. And if I got the 2x extender, the Sony's version of it anyways, for the 200 to 600, then I'd have 1200. And you know, I've been reading a lot of forums and watching a lot of reviews and all that kind of stuff, and people talk highly of both the lens and the extenders. So that's looking like that's going to be something in my future. However, comma, it's going to be way in my future because that lens is $2,000, and I think it's another $350 or $400 for the extender. Not happening anytime soon. Actually, when I started this whole video, I said that it might backfire on me. That's because it's been, mostly sunny, but some clouds all day. But it is now, where I'm going, definitely clouding up and looking like storm clouds. So I have a feeling that I don't want to get too far away from the 4Runner because in all likelihood, I'm going to get stuck in a pretty horrendous storm. And there's the first raindrop already. Shit. So yeah, I'm not going anywhere. It looks like I'm probably not going to be able to do this at all because it does look like it's going to get nasty. And given the storms that we had the past couple of days, I mean, I thought we were going to get a tornado. That's how bad it was. And with the lightning and everything, walking in the woods with a gigantic metal lens just doesn't seem to be a very smart thing to do. So we'll see. But if I can do it, I'll bring you along. If I can't, this is going to be a short video. Okay, so that was totally a bust. I got to the woods by the rec center. There's always some kind of water type fowl, bird or whatever, something there that I can take a picture of. And again, I had the A7 R4 with the Sigma 100 to 400, but I wanted to try it in APS-C mode so that I could get that 1.5 extra reach just to see what it looked like. And before I even got to the parking lot, it had started to rain and I was like, screw it, I'll get a little wet. I mean, I'm gonna be in the woods under the tree, so it won't be that bad. And I only want to get a couple of shots, and then kablammy, big strike of lightning hit. And I was like, okay, nope, not doing that. So I packed it in and I started to drive home, and it was a serious microburst again, to the point that traffic almost came to a halt because we couldn't see where the hell we were going and shit was going sideways. So I finally got home. I waited for it to stop raining enough that I could get out without getting drenched, and came inside, got myself all settled in, put everything away and all that kind of stuff, and looked outside and the sun was coming out. I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. So sometimes I'm not a dumb monkey. I went and I looked on the Weather Channel and watched the radar and saw that there were just waves of thunderstorms coming. So by the time I would have gotten redressed and gotten back to where I wanted to go, we're going to get hit with another one. So right now, it's already darkening again, and it's going to get pretty bad out. And it's supposed to do that through most of tonight. So no pictures today. And there you have it. That's the way it goes. It's tough when you're a photographer or a videographer and you want to go outside and play, but you're at the mercy of Mother Nature or somebody else's schedule. You got to make do with what you can. So when I was at the dealership this morning getting the maintenance done on my wife's vehicle, I actually did take a picture of the day, at least, and I decided that I didn't want to do a video like I did yesterday where I was just sitting there on a rock outside the dealership, and that's why I wanted to go out and test this out. Okay, back to what I was originally saying, the whole I want to get a lens with greater reach for birding and wildlife and all that kind of stuff, because that's actually starting to really become a passion of mine. I really have a lot of fun and I enjoy going out there and walking around and sort of stalking these birds and trying to get good pictures of them. This 100 to 400, trust me, it ain't bad. I mean, before that I was using the 70 to 200. I would have loved it if I could have used the extender, but since Sigma doesn't make one for Sony, I guess they have some kind of agreement. I was reading a bunch of threads and they were saying that they had to agree basically not to do certain things. So I think that's why they don't, one, have any extenders for the Sony line. They have them for their Sigma and Canon and every other mount, just not Sony. And they also don't have a 70 to 200 2.8. At this point, the 70 to 200, I think, even though it's 2.8, it's sort of as close enough to this 100 to 400 that I wouldn't buy it again anyways. But I would totally get that 200 to 600. Especially if I can get the Sony 2x extender for it and have basically a 400 to 1200 that seems to work rather well. So that's where I'm going with that. That's really all I've got for you today. If you're a Sony shooter, what lenses are you using? Especially if you're a Sony shooter and you're doing nature shit like I want to do, you know, with birds and animals and stuff out in the wild, so to speak. I'd love to know what solutions you've come up with to see if they will work for me. And again, that's all I got for you today. As always, thanks for joining me. Like, subscribe, and all that shit. And remember, kids, forward and up.